Hi, Seb from Shapr3D here. We're refreshing the Shapr3D user interface, and today I wanted to take a couple of minutes to give you a heads up and a little bit of a sneak peek into these changes. Shapr3D has changed a lot over the last couple of years. We've gone from being a 3D modeling application on the iPad to rolling out support for Windows and macOS, releasing 2D drawings, visualization, and the Shapr3D cloud. We're working hard to create a frictionless experience for product design and manufacturing themes. And in addition to the countless smaller improvements which we're always working on, we wanted to take a little bit of time to pause, look at the overall user experience, and make sure that Shapr3D remains as delightful and as intuitive to use as always. We're also working on a couple of larger, really exciting changes which you'll be hearing a lot about over the coming few months. And we wanted to make sure that we're creating the necessary space to accommodate these. Our goal with this refresh is to keep everything you love about Shapr3D and make sure we're able to provide the same great experience in the future. Although Shapr3D has gone from being an iPad application to rolling out on Windows and macOS, after releasing, we heard from many of you that Shapr3D on desktop still kind of felt like a tablet application. While we'll continue to prioritize providing the best CAD experience on tablet, with this refresh, we wanted to make sure that Shapr3D on desktop made the most of the extra screen real estate and better respected some typical desktop conventions. And we wanted to make sure that Shapr3D remains consistent across all platforms, so you can continue to easily pick up any device and work from where you need to be. Since launching 2D drawings and visualization, we heard from many of you how much you love being able to quickly jump from 3D modeling to drawing and into visualization when you're designing or collaborating with others. With this refresh, we're introducing the project sidebar, which will collect all of the artifacts of a given project in one space, no matter where they were created. This will make it even easier for you to get where you need to be, no matter which part of the Shapr3D ecosystem it was created in. It's been a priority for us to make sure we're making you more efficient with Shapr3D. And one of the ways we've done this in the past is Adaptive UI. Our Adaptive UI lets you always access the right tool for the job without needing to think where in the menu it's located. All you need to do is select the geometry you want to work with in the canvas and we'll take care of the rest. Our Adaptive UI isn't going away with this refresh, and we'll also be better surfacing a couple of newer tools like the measurement tool and isolate mode, which we've added recently. We know that changes like these can seem daunting, especially when you rely on Shapr3D professionally. It's been a top priority for us to make sure we're not introducing any new friction with this refresh. But if you have any questions, as always, feel free to reach out in the comment section of this video or through our usual support channels. You'll be hearing and seeing a lot more about this refresh and the other big changes I mentioned earlier over the coming weeks and months, so stay tuned. Until then, thanks so much and see you next time.